Good morning, good afternoon, greetings from Lima, Peru. This is Walter Castillo Urquiaga talking about cerebroplacental ratio and middle cerebral artery. And in cases of growth restriction like this, 36 weeks and 4 days, we have these values. Umbilical artery 1.14, normal centile, and middle cerebral artery 1.49, normal pulsatility index, normal centile. But the relation cerebroplacental ratio 1.30 is abnormal, lesser than the fifth centile, fourth centile. The CPR, the cutoff of fifth centile, alters before the middle cerebral artery or the umbilical artery and detects first the risk of hypoxia. This ratio results in an operational indicator of flow redistribution in growth-restricted viruses. We know that the umbilical artery have this tendency to increase according to gestational age, and the middle cerebral artery this tendency. However, in adequate and large viruses is different because the umbilical artery has a tendency of decrease in relation to gestational age as a physiological pregnancy, normal and physiological pregnancy, because there is no placental resistance increased. In this case, we show umbilical artery in ninth centile normal and middle cerebral artery in one centile, first centile, abnormal, very abnormal. But the CPR 1.19 is higher than the cutoff of fifth centile, the usual cutoff fifth centile. So, the CPR doesn't detect the risk of hypoxia in this case. It's a case with large fetuses that is already stillbirth. The CPR is normal despite dilation of the middle cerebral artery because the umbilical artery, the denominator, is normal. Remains normal. The middle cerebral artery detects so first than CPR the risk of hypoxia. The ratio results not useful as an operational indicator of flow redistribution in normal and large growth fetuses. Some investigations have changed the cutoff from 5th centile to 10th centile to detect the fetuses in risk of hypoxia, like this. For example, the CPR is in the 8th centile. However, given the obvious dilation of middle cerebral artery, we could be becoming operationalist and abandoning the physiological analysis. This case is evident in relation to the alteration of middle cerebral artery. Continuing evaluating just the umbilical artery in large and normal fetuses, in risk of hypoxia will continue, resulting in stillbirths and other adverse outcomes. In conclusion, we must understand that the Doppler translates a physiological response of protection, defense, or damage, which is evolutionary and dynamic. The abnormality of a fetal blood vessel is not always the first or the last to present the fetus before dying. If not, what was evaluated and reported? Let's investigate much more and better, because we are in times when even the physiological has to become evidence-based. Thank you.